Hello once again, our most valued student. My name is Confident and welcome to our 24-minute lesson. This is the ultimate guide in maths, science, career guidance, as well as a sneak peek into my personal experiences. This is a channel designed with you in mind. Let us dive into today's lesson. As we are continuing with the ultimate guide to organic chemistry, as we said, it comes in here with 15 hours of learning, and we've done quite a number of lessons, two lessons already. I will encourage you guys to check the previous lessons for you to understand what we are doing in this lesson. So as we continue here, we say the next lesson we are looking at is the hydrocarbons. And this is one of the most important lessons because the examiners love this section. Now, what is a hydrocarbon? You'll need first to define a hydrocarbon to say these are organic compounds that consist of hydrogen and carbon atoms only. This is where the mark is. If it's two marks, they'll mark you that, and they'll mark you that word only. So there'll be half mark there, and one mark there. Then they can give you two marks. It's a very, very important section, but you can look at the word hydro. So you know it consists of hydrogen and then carbons. It's simple that. But don't forget the word only, because there are some that consist of hydrogen and carbon and other atoms. But if you say only, you are trying to say you don't expect anything except hydrogen and carbon. Now, in these hydrocarbons, there are two types of hydrocarbons, which are saturated as well as unsaturated. So they will ask you to say state two types of hydrocarbons. You must say they are saturated hydrocarbons and they are unsaturated hydrocarbons. Now let's define each one of these. What is a saturated hydrocarbon? We are saying these are compounds in which there are no multiple bonds between carbon atoms in their hydrocarbon chains. I repeat again, these are compounds in which, don't forget, there are no multiple bonds. By multiple bonds, we say these are examples of multiple bonds: carbon double bond carbon or carbon triple bond carbon. So they are not there. So these are compounds in which there are no multiple bonds between carbon atoms in their hydrocarbon chains. But I prefer the second one. The second one says these are hydrocarbons that contain only single bonds. These are hydrocarbons. The moment you say hydrocarbon, you have already told us they contain only hydrogen and carbons. So these are hydrocarbons that contain only single bonds. So by saying they contain only single bonds, I'm already defining here hydrocarbons that hydrogen and carbon atoms only. Say they contain also only single bonds, meaning I will not find any multiple bonds. It's still maintaining that there are no multiple bonds. It's up to you how we want to define it. Let's look at the unsaturated hydrocarbon. What is the definition? It's the opposite. So you can do the opposite way. Say compounds with one or more multiple bonds. So here you expect to have a compound that is that, or the same compound can have that. Yes, good. This is a double or a triple bond. Then they call multiple bonds. So compounds with one or more multiple bonds between the carbon atoms in their hydrocarbon chains. Between, see, this is a carbon and this is another carbon. Hence it says between the carbon, one of their carbon chain atoms. Or you can say another definition, which I prefer. These are hydrocarbons that contain a double or triple bonds between two carbon atoms. You see, can have a double or triple bonds between two carbon atoms. And then examples here, it's alkenes and alkynes. Example here is alkanes. These are the three hydrocarbons that you'll be learning about: the alkanes, the alkenes, and the alkynes. So if you look at these, these two belong to unsaturated this one belongs to saturated. Now, with that, if I can take you again back to our structures, if you remember, the first lesson we had, I'm just going to be taking you through quickly through the lesson just to be for you to appreciate whether it's saturated or unsaturated. Let's look at this molecule, for example. Will you say this is a hydrocarbon? First of all, yes, this is a hydrocarbon. Why do we call this one a hydrocarbon? Number one, does it mean that it contains hydrogen? Suppose these white balls, it's a ball and stick, these white were hydrogens. So will you call it a hydrocarbon? The answer is yes, it ticks being a hydrocarbon. Why? Because the black represents carbon, as I said before, and then the white represents hydrogen. So it contains only hydrogen and carbon atoms. So it does pass that part, being hydrocarbon. Now the next one, is it saturated or unsaturated? This one will be what? It will be unsaturated. Now what is the reason being that? It has multiple bonds. It has multiple bonds. Now what are the multiple bonds? We are saying it has got a carbon, triple bond, carbon. There is a triple bond between the carbon atoms in here. And then here it has got carbon, double bond, carbon. There is a double bond in here. So the fact that it has got a triple bond and a double bond between the carbon atoms, it means it is unsaturated. We're going to explain some of this later. Now, what about this one? Is it a hydrocarbon? If the white represents hydrogen, yes, it's a hydrocarbon. Number two, saturated or unsaturated? What do you think? You are right. It is unsaturated. Why is it unsaturated? It's got a carbon, double bond, carbon. So this one has a double bond. You can actually say it is unsaturated because it has a double bond between carbon atoms. Carbon atoms. Or some they say it is a multiple bond, but to be correctly here, clear is that it is a double bond. So it is what? It is unsaturated. Okay, let me undo this. These structures can actually help. Here, they can give you this. We did this structural formula. From here, we can be able to tell whether this is a hydrocarbon. Yes, it's a hydrocarbon. Look at this. I'm using this structure now that I'm having here. I don't need to see the actual molecule. I can use this structure. It is a hydrocarbon. Why? Because there is only carbon and hydrogen here. Is it saturated or unsaturated? It is saturated here. Saturated. What's the reason for it to be saturated? It contains only single bonds. See, there are no multiple bonds here. So you can see only single bonds here. But even the structure, if you remember the structure, you see there are no double bonds. It was only single bonds. We also did the same here. This was saturated because it contained only single bonds. And then on this one also, we looked at it. It was also saturated. You can see here, this is saturated. Saturated. Why? Only single bonds. All right, it's a hydrocarbon. Yes, it's a hydrocarbon. Why? It contains only hydrogen and carbon atoms. All right, and then I told you that there are three types: alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. This is an alkane, just going ahead of myself here, but I will explain that later. So that is that. And then going previously, we're looking at this. This is also saturated and an alkane, and it is a hydrocarbon. So this one is a bit tricky to say at the moment because it's different atoms, but we cannot call it saturated. We cannot call it a hydrocarbon. This is not a hydrocarbon because we say the hydrocarbon contains only hydrogen and carbon atoms. So this is not a hydrocarbon. So guys, as we say, if we can recap on this lesson, you can come back here and say there are two types of hydrocarbons, and we said what are the house hydrocarbons? They are saturated or they are unsaturated. For saturated hydrocarbons, we're saying these are compounds with what, in which there are no multiple bonds between the carbon atoms. In other words, these are hydrocarbons that contains only single bonds. And then examples, you can give an example of an alkane. And then on the other side, unsaturated, these are compounds with one or more multiple bonds between the carbon atoms in their hydrocarbon chains, or they are hydrocarbons that contain a double or triple bonds between two carbon atoms in their hydrocarbon chains. And then examples are alkenes and alkynes. We have come to the end of our lesson. Now, in the next lesson that I want you to join, it is now us getting in detail to those. Remember, we're looking at the hydrocarbons. I said there are three of them. We said they are alkanes. So we're going to look in the next lessons at alkanes. We look then at alkenes in the other lesson and at alkynes. In that lesson, we're going to focus on some things here, which is what does it mean to be saturated? The naming of these, which is the homologous series, the structural formulas, the molecular formulas, the condensed structure, and the general formula. Join me again in the next lesson. Now, remember, guys, it's easier for you if you're subscribed. If you're subscribed, these lessons, you're going to be notified every time I'm uploading. Guys, subscribe. But some of you are also, I would say, not really to say you're selfish, but I would say you're not selling fish, of course, so you're not selfish. You are, in a way, withholding information. And in the court of law, to withhold information, you are going to be charged as guilty. So I'm saying you're guilty if your friend is not benefiting. Just show some kind of care and love by sharing this to someone who think might need this. Even on your group, on your Facebook, on your groups, guys, at school, whether it's your WhatsApp groups and everything, just share this channel. It is going to assist quite a lot of people, because by doing that, you can be actually changing a life. So share this channel with your friends and your colleagues. Until then, see you again. Thank you.